Hello, Divi Nation, and welcome. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to showcase features in hover tabs with Divi. This is the final result we're aiming to achieve. So without wasting a lot of time, let's dive in and let's get started. So let's start by creating a brand new page. So I'm going to come over here to Pages, click on Add New. And for my page title, I'm going to call this Hover Tabs. And then I'm going to click on Use the Divi Builder. And for this, I'm going to build from scratch. Okay, so now that we're here, for now, I'm just going to close this and then I'm going to come over here to the top left and click on this gear icon to access the section settings, because the first thing we're going to do here is to add a gradient background. So I'm going to come over here to background, click on the second tab and then click this plus button. So here on my first color, I'm going to paste my color in here. Now, if you want to use the exact same colors as I'm using throughout this tutorial, I will leave a link in the show notes so you can go to the post which has all these settings. Right, so I'm going to paste my color in here, and then I'm going to come to the second tab, and my color here is going to be white, so I'm going to choose my white color here. Now, let's head over to the gradient direction, so I'm going to scroll down here, and by default, it's set to 180 degrees, so we want this to be 87. So moving on, our start and end position needs to be set at 20% and end position 20%. Now let's head over to the design tab and add our padding. So I'm going to click here on spacing, and for the top and bottom padding, we're going to set this to 0. Add my value here and then activate this chain so that my value is added both to the top and the bottom. And then let's go ahead and save. Right. So the next stage now is to add our row. So I'm going to click here on this plus button, and I need a single column. So I'm going to select this. So for now, we're not going to add any modules yet. So let's close this and then go to our row settings. So I'm going to click here on row settings, click on background. And the first thing we need to do here is to add our white background color. So I'm going to click here on add background color and select white. So the next thing we're going to do is to go to our row alignment. So I'm going to click here on design alignment, and this needs to be aligned to the left. So I'm going to choose left. Now let's head over here to the sizing. So we're going to click on the sizing tab. And here the first thing we need to do is to activate use custom size. So I'm going to select yes and change my unit to pixels. So make sure that here you have it at pixels. And then here the pixel width needs to be 400. And then over here on use custom gutter width, let's choose yes. Now the custom gutter width is the distance between the columns. So we want to set this to 1. Because we don't want any spaces between our columns. Now over here on the custom width, let's add also a hover effect. So I'm going to click here on this arrow, click here on hover, and we are going to change this value from 400 to 1200, I mean to 2000. Okay, so this is what's going to happen when we hover. Now let's head over here to our spacing and also add our padding. So for the padding here, we're going to add 0, both to the top and the bottom. And then next we're going to come over here to the border. So what we're going to do here is we're going to add a left border. So I'm going to choose my left tab here. And we're also going to add the size, which is going to be 20 pixels. So I'm going to add my size here. And then we need to add our custom color. So my color here, I'm going to click on this eyedropper tool and paste my color in here, just like that. Okay. So now we can see that we have this left border here all the way at the top. And on the top here as well, we're going to add 20 pixels for the rounded corner. But the thing is, we don't want this 20 pixels to be going across all the four sides. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come here and break this chain and then add my value. Now, while we're here, what we also need to do is to add the hover state. So I'm going to click here on this little arrow, click on hover, and this time we're going to remove the 20 pixels. Next, let's head over here to our box shadow. So I'm going to click here on box shadow and choose my first option. So for the blur strength, we're going to set this to 80, the spread strength to minus 10. And then finally, I'm going to come over here to my shadow color and add my color. So here, I'm just going to replace my color by adding mine between the brackets. So now let's add our hover state. So I'm going to click here on this little icon, click here on hover, and then click on the eyedropper tool and paste my values between the brackets. And as I mentioned before, if you want to use the exact same values as I'm using throughout this tutorial, I will leave a link to the post in the show notes below. So now that we've added all this, it's time now to save and then add our modules. So I'm going to click here on this plus button, and the module that we need is a blurb module. So I'm going to select it. Now, in this example, I'm using a blurb, but of course, you can use any other module that you want. So let's go ahead now and start customizing this. So the first thing we're going to do here is to head over here to the title and call this feature. For our text, I'm just going to leave my default text in here, but you can add whatever text that you need in this area here. Now let's select an icon. So right now, by default, it comes in with an image. So I'm going to come over here to image and icon and then select use icon. Now again, over here, you can use any icon that you want to use, but I'm just going to go ahead and choose this folder icon. Next, let's customize our icon. So I'm going to come over here to design, image and icon. So the first thing I'm going to do is to give my icon a color. So I'm going to click here on the eyedropper tool and paste my color in here like that. Next, I'm going to make sure icon placement is set to top. So here it's set to top and then use icon font size. I need to say yes to that. Now, the reason why we use icon font size in this case is to customize the size of this icon. So right now it's a bit too big and I'm not happy with that. So I'm going to click here on use icon font size. Now, once that's activated, this is where now you can enter your specific size for your icon. And as you see, the moment I've added 54, now it's reduced in size. Right, so the next thing we need to do is to customize our text title. So I'm going to come over here and our font is going to be Poppins. So I'm going to come over here to the top and search for it. Select it. Text alignment. This needs to be centered. So I'm going to select my center here. And we also need to give this a text color. So I'm going to click on the eyedropper tool, paste my text color here to match my icon. And the text size needs to be set to 25. So currently it's at 18. So I'm going to make it slightly bigger. And then I am going to head over to the letter spacing and set it to -1. And then finally here on the line height, I'm going to make sure it's set to 1 em. Now, while we're here on the text line height, we also need to add a hover effect. So I'm going to click here on this arrow and set and make sure I click on the hover tab. And then I'm going to set my hover state value to 1.5 em. So you can see here as I cycle through these two, there's a slight shift in the line height. Now let's head over to the body text and make some customizations there. So I'm going to come over here and for our body font as well, we're going to make sure we choose Poppins, just to make sure that we match with our title. And we're also going to go to the body weight and set it to light. Choose light here, and we're going to align this to the center so that it's also in line with our title here and our icon. Great. So moving on, our body text color needs to be black. So I'm going to make sure I choose black here. Okay, so over here on the body text size, I'm going to set this to 0. And I might as well enter my values for the smartphone and the tablet. So I'm going to click here on this little icon, click on the tablet. And the value here on the tablet is going to be 15 pixels. And that's also going to be the same for the phone. And for the body line height, I'm going to set this to 2.2. Now let's head over back to our sizes for our body text. So we want to also add our hover state. So I'm going to click here on this little arrow. So I'm going to click on hover and add 15 pixels to our size. So this text will only appear when I hover over this. So let me just show you quickly what that looks like. So that's the normal state, and then that's the hover state. Now it's time to add our padding. So I'm going to close all, I'm going to scroll all the way down here to spacing. And for our top and bottom padding, we're going to set this to 80. Activate my chain. Right. So the next thing we're going to do here is to enter our hover state. So I'm going to click here on this little tab. So over here on the hover, 80 pixels is fine. But over here on the left and right, we're going to set this to 20 pixels. So I'm pretty much happy with all that we've done so far. So I'm going to go ahead now and save. Okay, so now that we've designed this, the next thing we're going to do now is to duplicate this a few times. And to do that, we need to come over here to our row settings and do this a few times. I'm just going to do it twice, but in your case, you can do it as many times as you want. Right, so now that I've duplicated these, the next stage I need to go into now is to go into the row settings and click here on design, spacing, and add my left margins. So here I'm going to add 6VW, and you can see here as soon as I've entered that value, now they are now staggered. They're not in a straight line anymore, and this is exactly what we need to do. So I'm going to save this for now. So the next one can be set to 12VW. So I'm just going to hover over here, click on my row settings, design, spacing, and margin left, 12VW. And now you can see that they are placed correctly. Okay, so what we're going to do next is to go in and just customize the rest of our icons here and also the rows. So I'm going to start off here with my row, the second row. So I'm going to click here on row settings. And then to make things easy for me, I'm just going to come to the filter and look at the modified style. So this will just break down all the styles that I've modified. Okay, so I'm going to scroll down here and start off with my border. So I'm going to start here with my left border. So I'm going to click here on the icon and then I'm going to change my color right here. Like that. Next, we're also going to change the blurb content and icon. So I'm going to save this for now. Click here on my module settings, design, image and icon. So I'm going to match my color to my left border here. So I'm going to click on my eyedropper tool and paste my color just like that. I'm going to come back over here to my content tab, image and icon. And this time I'm just going to choose a different icon. But as I mentioned before, you can use any icon that you want in here. So I'm just going to go ahead and choose this lock. And now we can see that the title here is needs also to be changed. So I'm going to click here and change the title color as well. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Right. So let's go ahead now and save. So now that you've seen how I managed to change these colors, go ahead and do that to the rest of the rows. Okay. So now that I've added all my features, the next stage now is to save this page and do a quick preview. Save this page. And in fact, before I do that, let's just make sure that everything looks great on different mobile devices. So this is my tablet view. So all the content is visible, which is great. And this is my mobile view. Great. Okay, so now let's preview our design. So I'm going to click here on save. And then we're going to go ahead and exit the Visual Builder. And now let's see if it works. So if I hover over here, you can see now that when I hover, it reveals all my features. So there you have it. Thank you all for watching. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and do follow us on our social media platforms. By doing so, you'll be notified every time we release new tutorials. And if you have any questions regarding this tutorial, please leave your questions in the comments box below and I'll do my best to respond to those questions. Until next time, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.